If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome to lecture 14 of our protection part. So you are doing this problem in the last class. There was a coordination problem of primary and backup relay, which we are solving. So here in the question, there was two relay. So you have seen last time that we have how we will proceed the questions. The algorithm we have seen. Today we will solve the numerical. So in the question, there was mentioned that you have to do it coordination using DTOC relay, definite time delay DTOC overcurrent relay. So to solve this one, you first identify which was the primary relay and backup relay, the primary backup pairs, how many pairs are possible. So this question becomes easy because here only two relays are there. So this becomes my primary, and if it fails, it should. But this job is little bit tricky if the number of relays become more. So you will see these questions in coming days, and there is directional features are also there. But for now, it is okay. This one is my primary, this is my backup. So this pair I have got. So first you have to find out the possible pairs of primary backup, primary and secondary. Another thing I want to explain, here some fault currents is given. To remove your confusion, what does this fault current represent? Let me explain one more time. What is this one representing? This one representing any fault. What is maximum one representing? This one, the maximum fault current. Maximum fault current 4000 is representing that a major fault has been occurred near to the bus A. A very major fault, a very near to bus A has been occurred. That's why the maximum fault is 4000 ampere. If it happens, then maximum current that will pass through this bus is 4000 ampere. Coming out of this bus A is 4000 ampere. What is the minimum current? That means a very less severe fault has occurred as far as possible from A. Somewhere here it happened for 3500 I am talking. A very less severe fault which has occurred as far as A. Similarly, you got it, na? Similarly for B, a very severe fault has occurred. Very severe fault is occurred near B. That's why the current is 3000. 2000 means a less severe field occur. Severe fault is occurred as far as possible from point B. Similarly for C, because C far is not possible. C itself is the last end. So everything in is in C. So 1500 for C. This 1500 is here only. Maximum severe fault. This 1000 is less severe fault. That's it. So now let's start. So we will start from the tail end, that is relay B. So if we start with relay B, okay, from here onwards we will starting the solution. So for relay B, what we will take? We will take, because relay B is in our hand, so we will make it as fast as possible. So the fastest possible is, let's take it is 0.1 second, because this is the normally the fastest possible time for me. So I will keep it at 0.1 second. So what should be my relay? Because it is DTOC relay, here the time doesn't depend on current. Every time the time will remain fixed, because whatever the fault current is, DTOC relay, always you remember the curve of DTOC relay. This was the curve of DTOC relay. It is flat. So there is no as such change in this operating time. This time is doesn't changing so much with the time. Doesn't change at all, you can think. With current, whatever the current is, it will be fixed. So time calculation becomes easy for me here. So what will be the time of A? It will be the time of B plus circuit breaker rating operating time of B. We have already studied this one, how these times are coming. This is overshoot time, I have told you yesterday, to get rid of that inertia. So if we add this one, 0.1 is the what we have considered is relay operating time, 0.5 is the standard breaker operating time, and 0.2 is the overshoot time. Suppose we have considered 0.2 second. So what is the time? It is 0.8 second. And these two, if you add, that is known as selective STI, selective time interval. That is known as STI. Okay, now if it is a 0.8 second, now it is done. So relay B will operate after 0.1 second irrespective of fall current. Relay A will operate at a 0.8 second irrespective of fault current, irrespective of fault location also. Wherever the fault occurs, B will be operating at 0.1 second and A will operate after 0.8 second. Okay. Now let us calculate the current settings. Now if we are calculating the current settings, what is the circuit breaker B, CTB, suppose if I am taking. So CTB, what is the normal current flows through CTB? You can see what is the normal load current in B. If you see the load, normal load current passing through B is this current, because this is coming before, this current is coming through A. This is not going through B. So going through that relay B, the relay is operated here, the relay B is here, and this is relay A. So you can think, so relay B or CTB, this is the CTB. So the current throwing through, passing through CTB is this load current under normal condition, and current passing through CTA is this plus this for A. For B it is only this. So if you see this one for plug setting, what will be the CT ratio? This current, that is load C current, it was flowing through CTB, how much it is? 80, then multiplied by a factor 1.25. what is the 1.25? this is the overload capacity. 80 is the normal current that is flowing, but I am giving a safety margin, it can flow little bit more. Beyond that we will consider it as a fault. So the safety margin is 0.25. so 100 ampere is my, I can think of, that is the current that I will allow under normal condition. Anything above 100 ampere should trip. So what will be my CT ratio? 100:1. You can consider. So plug setting, how what I will take plug setting? I will take 1 ampere itself as a plug setting, because 100 ampere I have already given the overload limit. So that's why my plug setting is at 100%. That is, in normal condition the current is 80. So 80 means 0.8 ampere will flow. I have given a safety margin of 0.2. So I am setting at 1 ampere. So that's why there was no need of increasing this plug setting. In your question number 2, the plug setting was 125%. So they might have taken the normal current 80 ampere itself. So they have considered CT, that suppose 80:1. So normal condition 1 ampere will flow. So they will keep margin here 1:1.25. Anything above 1.25 will trip the circuit. But here we have already considered 0.25 in the CT primary current itself. Extra, that overload, that's why I am not considering this one in plug setting. I am keeping it as 100% itself. For CTA, what will be the normal current? 160 plus 80 multiplied by 25% overload, which is 300 ampere. So again, what will be CT ratio? 300:1. What is the plug setting? Because I have considered already overload there, so I will plug set at 1 ampere only, because in normal condition 2.4. 160 plus 80 is 240. 300:1. If it is 300, then it is 1. So if it is 240, how much you calculate, that will be less than 1. So I have already given some margin, that's why I am setting 1 at my threshold limit. Now after doing this, can you find any flaw in the DTOC relay? You think of time perspective, the time set, this time perspective, there is a problem. Why? Because the time you have fixed for relay A and relay B, relay A it is 0.8, relay B it is 0.1. now suppose there is not, that is more number of relays are there, not only 2, 3, 4, 5. So as you proceed from tail end, here we have gone from B to A. Now suppose there is another one behind A, that is C, B, A, C. Now if you move to C, then time will again increase. You will add 0.8 plus 0.5 plus 0.2. these two again you will add, breaker time and overshoot time. So you will add 0.7 again, so it will be 1.5. if you go back again, there is a, suppose another relay behind C also, then the time is increasing. So what is happening? Any fault near A will not be tripped before 8.8. Similarly, if it is in C, the time will increase more and more. So which is undesirable. We don't, so any severe fault also occurring in A, suppose in AB section, AB section BC is not work, because for AB section A is the primary itself. You see the drawing, you can, I think you have already downloaded that. So in the drawing itself, in the AB section, the relay B will not operate, a relay A will operate, because it, the primary is relay A here. So, but your setting is, you have already given 0.8 setting, so it will not operate beyond, before 0.8. So this is the undesirable properties. If you go, if it is, the feeder is very long, there are so many feeders in backups, and their fault current is varying. So for severe faults, for the relay which are near to source, it will take much longer time to trip, because your setting is keep on increasing the time. So at point will come which is which will be undesirable. There is no purpose of giving protection if that fault is cleared after 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 5 seconds. By that time everything will be gone. So that is the flawbacks of the DTOC relay. So how we will solve it? We can use IDMT relay, because what is the property of IDMT relay? If you see IDMT relay, they explore the inverse characteristics very much. If the I is increasing, this is reducing. So time is not fixed. So for severe fault, this current will decrease. For severe fault, sorry, current will increase, this time will decrease. So we'll see this one how. So this question itself, the same question, now we'll be doing the coordination problem using now IDMT relay. Earlier was DTOC relay. So in IDMT relay, the time setting is not the as simple as DTOC relay. So we'll start with first CT ratio, then we'll come to the time setting. First fix me the CT ratio. So let the CT secondary current is 1 ampere. Again, the maximum current for CT B is, I have taken already 25% overload, so 100 ampere. CT A, again, these two load current will be passing through CT A. 25% overload, so current is 300 ampere. So the ratio I have got for CTB and CTA, 100:1 and 300:1. Good. What will be the plug setting? Because I have already taken the overload, so plug setting I can take 100%. That means for both these relay, the plug setting will be, for B also, for A also, the plug setting is 1 ampere. For anything above 1 ampere in the CT secondary current, it should trip. Now this is making sense with this one extra line I have written in brackets, so that you understand the concept. This is not in the solution of the numerical. This makes sense as the overloads are already considered in the primary current and CT ratio. You have already considered 25%. That's why plug setting of 100% is okay. There is no need of going beyond 100%, because already you have given overload in the primary current calculation itself, or in the CT ratio itself. Now the time setting should be, now how you will set the TMS? Is it based on your maximum fault current? Is it based on your minimum fault current? And which location? Is it relay CTB? There are three different fault currents you will find, bus A, bus B, bus C. Either we will take bus A, bus B, bus C, or we will take maximum or minimum. Now you think, what should be my, I need to have a good primary backup relay coordination. That is my intention, so that selectivity is maintained. So when this coordination is at risk, it is at risk when the system is operating at its fastest mode, that is when the maximum current is going through it. So when the maximum current is going through it, when there is a coordination between primary and backup, so the fault should be near bus B. If it is in near bus A, then relay B will not work. There is no coordination between A and B. The coordination between A and B will occur when both are involved. So when both are involved, there are two cases. One is fault near bus C or fault near bus B. These two conditions. Now I need to have the maximum fault current. So maximum fault current will occur near bus B, you can see. And the maximum fault current is 3000 ampere. So if I calculate for the maximum fault current, which is passing through both the relays, and if I can coordinate the coordination between primary backup for that maximum current, it is likely that for fault currents less than that 3000 ampere, that coordination will exist. We are getting it now? For maximum fault current, it will rotate fast. So if I can control that, both are rotating fast, So we can get the exact time difference between these two, so that one trips if one fails. So it is very likely that it will also work in a condition when it is rotating slow. So that's why you are considering max. This is the worst case scenario you have to consider. So what is the worst case? Worst case is the maximum fault current that is seen by the both the primary relay and the backup relay. Okay. So here my primary relay is B. So what is the maximum current it is seeing? It is seeing 3000 ampere as a maximum current. So any fault near bus B. So what is the CT secondary current for that maximum current? 300 ampere, because your CT ratio is 100:1 for B. So what is PSM for relay B? It is CT secondary current divided by the plug setting you has given. Sorry, PSM, there will be no ampere. There is no unit for PSM. It is just a ratio. So it is 30 only. There is no ampere. You remove that ampere part. So PSM of relay B is 30. So once you know PSM, now you can start calculating the time. So this is the relation I am taking. There are three relations. You can see IDMT, inverse, very inverse. So I am taking only inverse one. This formula we have given, the operating time of a IDMT relay. So this is the formula. So what I am considering for, I have not written here. Na? Okay, let me write it here. So let TMS for relay B is 0.1. This is the fastest. 0.1. This is the fastest case that I have posed. 0.1 means it will rotate only 10%. This is very near to trip. A small rotation will hit the target. So that is 0.1, not 0.1 second. TMS is, again, it is a multiplier setting. It is not in second. It is in 0.1. Like your PSM. No ampere, no. In TSM, TMS also, there is no second. So if we apply this one, that's why I have here 0.1 I have taken. This is the fastest, this is in my hand. This is of B I am talking about, because I am starting from B. B you can take anything, so obviously you will take the first. Accordingly, A will depend. So PSM was 30, so if you calculate the time is, how much time it is? 0.2 second. So what should be the time of A? A time will be this time plus breaker operating plus threshold. Here threshold I have taken 0.1. I think last time also I have taken 0.1 only, or 0.2, let me see. Oh, here I have taken 0.2. Oh, no issue. You can take anything. Here safety margin I have reduced it a little bit. So 0.1. So this is 0.1 I have taken. So this is coming at 0.8 second. Here safety margin I have given 0.1 second. Okay. Now, what is the maximum fault current in BC? Now you are getting operating time, but you don't know the time setting of the relay A, TMS. So for calculating TMS, again you need to use this relation. So again, we will be using this. For that, we need to find PSM and PSM for relay A. So what is the maximum fault current that we are considering? 3000 ampere. So if 3000 ampere is flowing, so what will be the CT secondary current of the backup relay? That is A, 10 ampere. What is PSM? That 10 ampere divided by 1. This ratio I have given, taken here. So 10 by 1. So what is PSM of A? It is 10. So now for 10, if you calculate the time, for TSMA, this is the relation of time. This time you know now, because it should operate at 0.8 second. So what should be my TMS? TMS is 0.269. I will place the disk in a position where it is near about 0.27. Now what is the advantage here? The advantage here, because you have fixed TSM for this relay A, now with the fault current increasing, your PSM will keep on increasing. As your PSM increasing, this operating time will get reduced. It is not now fixed. It is not now fixed at 0.8. This is not fixed now. As DTOC relay, it was fixed. But here it is depending on this relation. You are fixing only TMS. The disk position you are fixing. So if PSM, your fault current increases this PSM, then automatically your time will reduce. So this is the advantage we are getting. For severe faults near A relay, it will not wait up to 0.8, it will act before 0.8 second, because here the coordination is not an issue. Here the relay A itself is the primary, because the fault is occurring in the AB section only. So for more faults in AB section, A will trip before 0.8, which was not possible in DTOC. DTOC fixed the time. So this is the advantage of your IDMT relay. You can see, as fault takes near the source, PSM will increase of A relay and associated operating time of the relay will decrease, which is unlikely in DTOC relay, while maintaining selectivity. It will maintain selectivity. It will not that the backup and primary both are operating at the same time. But your DTOC is cheaper and IDMT cheaper than IDMT, because design is very simple. So DTOC relay, where will you use? DTOC relay you will use for the protection of short feeders, where the number of relays are less and the fault current doesn't change so much. The fault current is not changing so much, so that there is no question of increasing fault current. There is no question of reduction of tripping time for more severe faults. So almost the fault current remains more or less constant irrespective of fault location. Why this will happen? This will happen because feeder is very small. The feeder impedance is negligible with compared to your source impedance. If the feeder is more long, then more and more impedance will come into the picture. That will change the fault current level as per the location of the faults. And for long lines, we will be using IDMT relays. So next day, what we will do, how these relays are, now for overcurrent relay, for three phase, you need three overcurrent relay in per phase, for each phase, R phase, Y phase, B phase. But you will see, in practice, we will be using two overcurrent relay and one earth fault relay. One overcurrent relay will be used in earth path. Why this is so, how this is connected in practical life, we will see in next class. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.